Imagine making an entire song in seconds with the Song Maker feature in the new Magix Music Maker 2021 Premium Edition. You can. I'm Zane. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. And just so you know, I've linked to Magix's website below in case you want to download this latest version, get some more info, and there is a free version out there, but it doesn't include this feature that I'm talking about today. And I'm also going to look at how to get 4 free sound pools a little later on in this video, so be sure to stick around for that. Now let's look at the Song Maker feature. All right, let's start a new project. And then down in this bottom area, if you don't have it enabled, you can click right here to enable this area. You want to click on the Song Maker tab. And then over here, you'll see some genre templates. If you click on one of the primary genres, we'll click on dance. You're going to see some subgenres in there. So click on whatever genre you want. I'm going to go to dance, and then we'll go to electro house. So click on that. And now you want to go to the sound pools area. And in here you can select one or more sound pools that you want to add to this song. So I'm going to select a couple in here. I'll choose 80s synth wave and the Stranger Synths. And I'll also choose pure rock here. And then over here, you can choose the instruments that you want in your song. So I only want one bass. I'll unclick that. You notice if it's white, that means it's clicked. If it's gray, that's unclicked. And to deselect it, you just click it again. And that's it. And that's the same thing over here. Just click it again to get rid of it. And then after you have all your instruments selected, you want to select your song parts. So I'm going to go with just one intro. We'll have intro A. Then we're going to go into main, a build-up, drop A, and I'm not going to do drop B. Then we'll go into main B, breakdown A, breakdown B, and we'll just leave the rest how it is. So this is going to be our song. When you're ready, just click create song. And now you can see it's putting our song together here. Okay, it looks like it's done. Let's give it a listen. So that's not too bad for just a few seconds of work, but this is where you can truly start to make this track your own by adjusting the levels. So you could just go over here and you can adjust the levels, maybe turn down some things or turn up some things if you need to. You can also go in and add some effects to different tracks. So maybe you on your drums, you want to go to the audio effects rack track and maybe go with the compressor here. Or of course you can add one of your own VST effects. And another way you can make this your own is you'll see up here on the pitches bar, it has A, AC. You can change these around so you can really make this song your own. Now let's listen to how this sounds as A, how it was. All right, so I'm going to change that to C now. We'll hear how it sounds. So you can really change this around and make it your own. Of course, you can add other parts into it using either the sound pools or your own loops. Plus, you can record your voice into it or another instrument like guitar or maybe one of the MIDI instruments in here. What the Magix Music Maker Song Maker does is it gives you a nice starting point to work with. Or if you're new to music production and you want to practice your mixing skills a bit, this is a perfect place to start and do that. Even if you choose the exact same template and sound pools, it's supposed to create a different track every time, so you have a lot of opportunities to practice your skills here. Now let's go through the process again, selecting the same template, the same sound pools, and everything the same, and we'll see what we get. Now before we do that, I just want to ask, if you're enjoying this video so far, can you please hit that thumbs up button? It really helps my channel out and I appreciate it so much. Now let's get back into Music Maker. So now we're going to be choosing everything the same. We can just hit the create button over here again, as it's everything's still selected the same. So we'll just hit create song again. It's going to ask if we want to save that, and you can if you want. I'm not going to save this project right now. And here it is creating a whole new song for us. So let's have a listen to see if it's any different. And you can see in here that it's different from the last song, even though everything we selected was the same. So if you have sound pools that complement each other, this is going to be great, but you can try mixing some sound pools that you might not normally try mixing together, and you can see what this comes up with. And just in case you're not aware of the 4 free sound pools that you can download, I'll show you how to do that right now. So let's click here to bring up the store. And then if this is something different, you want to change it to sound pool. So you would just click there, click on sound pools. And then over here where it says price, yours might say name, but you want it to say price ascending. So you would just click on that. And now you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. These 4 are free sound pools that you can download. You would just click on them and you would then click buy, but it would say $0, and you can go through the process that way for each one of these. Be sure to download those so you have even more loops to work with in the song maker. Now let's try mixing some more sounds together. Let's go to a rock sound and we're going to go with pop rock, no time. And for sound pools, we're going to choose that free rock one that we just got. But I'm also going to mix in something else. Let's try some hip hop in there. That's normally not something you would go with for rock. And we'll also add 80s too hot in there. And we'll see what it comes up with. We'll leave all the instruments the same here. And for the song parts, I'm going to take out intro B. We only need one intro and we'll go right into the chorus like it says. We'll leave everything the same other than changing the intro. Click create song. And now let's hear what this sounds like. All right, so that's a very 80s rock song, but what do you expect with the sound pools that I chose there? But again, you go in, you start the mixing process and maybe add your voice or some other instruments in there, and these songs can really become something that you're proud of. One thing you might want to note is you can post all of your songs to YouTube, SoundCloud, or wherever, as long as you're not monetizing them. If you want to monetize the songs that you create using the sound pools, you have to purchase a commercial license for each sound pool that you use. But if you're just posting in free places and not making any money, go for it, as these can help to get your name out there and it can help you really enhance your mixing skills and also develop your own style. Now, if you're just using your own loops and your own voice and your own instruments, things like that, you don't need a commercial license. You can post those songs and make money on them all you like. If you want to see even more Magix Music Maker videos, click up here. Or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.